गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। टुडे वी विल बी गोइंग टू रीड अबाउट चैप्टर 3, दैट इज सीमेंट मोर्टर एंड कंक्रीट। ओके, यू ऑल हैव बीन सीन द सीमेंट एंड वी आर यूजिंग द सीमेंट इन आवर कंस्ट्रक्शन मटेरियल्स, यू हैव बीन सीइंग। ओके, तो वी कैन से दैट द सीमेंट इज वन टाइप ऑफ अ मटेरियल, कंस्ट्रक्शन मटेरियल, एंड यू हैव ऑल्सो बीन सीइंग द मोर्टर, यू हैव बीन सीइंग कंक्रीट, you have been placed in our houses or we are using in our construction sites the concrete we have been using. Okay, so we will be reading about, in this chapter we will be reading about cement, what are the types of cement, what are the properties of the cement, and how the cement is manufactured, what are the process of manufacturing of the cement. And next we'll be reading about mortar, what do you mean by mortar and what are the types of mortar, and what are the sources and classifications of the sand, bulking of the sand. And we will be reading about what are the uses of gravel, morum and the fly ash as a different building material, we will be reading about that. And next we'll be reading about the concrete, what do you mean by concrete and what are the compositions of the concrete, or what do you mean by water cement ratio, what do you mean by workability, and what are the mechanical properties and grading of aggregates, mixing, while we are mixing the aggregates or placing, compacting or transporting and curing the aggregates to a one place to another. Okay, this will be reading in this chapter. Okay, so first we will be reading about what is cement, or we can tell introduction to cement, or what do you mean by cement. You can see here the diagram, I have shown you the diagram here, what do you mean by cement. Okay, cement, you can see this type of a cement, you can know, you have been all been acquainted with the cement. Okay, so we can say that cement is one type of a binding material, and it is a substance which is used for constructions that sets or hardens or adheres to other materials to bind them together. Okay, if we place a brick with each other, and we make a cement paste. Okay, we make a cement paste and we set the two bricks with each other. Okay, so we can say that it sets or it hardens quickly, and it binds the particles, or it binds the stone, we can say, or any types of substances, we can bind them together. Okay, and it is used for making mortar and concrete. Also, cement is used for making mortar. Mortar will be reading in the next slide. Okay, mortar is known as this type of a cement, or water paste we can say that is type of a mortar. And what do you mean by concrete, we will be reading in the next slide. Concrete made is the mixture of cement, water and aggregates. Okay, we can say that is concrete. And cement contains in the mixture of calcareous, siliceous, argillaceous and other substances. Okay, cement contains these types of substances. Then again, cement binds fine aggregates and coarse aggregates together. Okay, cement binds the fine aggregates. Fine aggregates we can say sand, and coarse aggregates we can say gravel, stones. We can say these are the coarse aggregates. Okay, you can see here the bricks that is placed here, and here in the middle of the two bricks that the cement paste has been made. Okay, you can see here the diagram. Next we'll be reading about what are the physical properties of cement. Okay, as we know, it gives strength to the masonry. Okay, and it is an excellent binding material. It is easily workable. It offers good resistance to the moisture. It possesses good plasticity. It hardens and stiffens easily. Okay, you have been seeing, while we are using the cement paste, it gives strength to our masonry, to our any of the structures, and it is an excellent binding material, and it is easily workable, we can work it easily, and it possesses good plasticity, it hardens and stiffens easily. Okay, and also cement offers a good resistance to the moisture. Okay, next we will be reading about grades of the cement. What do you mean by grades of the cement? As we know, there are three types of grades of the cement. Okay, we can say that is grade 33, grade 43, grade 53. Okay, there are three types of cement. So we can say that in the grade 33, it contains 33 newton. It means its strength, cement of the strength is 33 newton per millimeter square. And in grade 43, it contains 43 newton per millimeter square. And in grade 53, it contains 53 newton per millimeter square. Okay. So, we can say in grade 33, it mainly while we are using the grade 33 cement. Okay. We are in the previous years, we are using grade 33 cement. Okay. In nowadays, we are using the highest strength of the cement. That you can say that is grade 53. We are using nowadays. Okay. So, in grade 33, it is used in these types of cement are used in making general construction work, or we can say small construction work, mass concrete, plain plastering, precast blocks, flooring. Okay, this we are using in a grade 33, and it is used as a lace with the availability of the grade 43 and the 53. And we can say that while you are using the grade 33 cement, in 3 days the strength is 16 newton per millimeter square. Okay, and in 7 days, after the 7 days, the strength of the cement is 22 newton per millimeter square. And after 28 days, we can get the grade of 33 cement strength is 33 newton per millimeter square. Okay. So, after that, we'll be reading about grade 43. Okay. As we know, grade 43 attains 43 newton per millimeter square, and it is used in making medium structures, precast blocks, plastering, flooring, and RCC pipes. Okay. The next is, it is used as maximum in our construction site. It is also used as it. Okay. Next, in 3 days strength, we take as 23 newton per millimeter square. After in 7 days, if we test the strength of the rough cement, of that cement, then we can say that it is 33 newton per millimeter square. And after that, if we get 28, after 28 days, we get 43. Okay. So, in grade 53, at last in grade 53, it is used in our making strong structures. So, we can say that strong structures means bridges, highway, railways, high-rise buildings, or we can say apartments, or we can say roads, concrete roads, precast pavement blocks, or any type of a high cast structures. Okay. These types of grade cement requires more care. Okay. In 3 days strength, it takes 27 newton per millimeter square. After in 7 days, it takes 37 newton per millimeter square. And in 28 days, it takes 53 newton per millimeter square. Okay. So, we'll be reading about what are the compositions of ordinary cement. Okay. Compositions of ordinary cement means what? Means in the cement, what are the ingredients have been used? Okay, in the cement. We can say there are some types of ingredients. You can see here, I have shown you the ingredients. That is lime, silica, alumina, calcium sulfate, iron oxide, magnesia, sulfide, alkali. These are the ingredients we can say. Okay. So, we can say that in lime, it is one of the type of a ingredients in the ordinary cement, and in lime, it contains 62% of the lime in cement. Okay. And its range is 62 to 67. And in silica, its percentage in the cement is 22. Okay. And its range is 17 to 25%. And in cement, the alumina contains 5%, whereas its range is 3 to 8%. Okay. And in cement, the calcium sulfate contains 4%. Okay. Its range is 3 to 4%. Okay. And in iron oxide, you can see the percentage in the cement is 3%. And the range is 3 to 4%. And in magnesia, the cement contains 2% of magnesia. And its range is 1 to 3. And in sulfide, the percentage is 1%. And it contains 1 to 3%, and in alkalis it contains 1%, and this range is 0.2 to 1%. Okay. So harmful constituents of the cement we will be reading in the next class. Okay. Thank you.